All right, the Hill's John Solomon, he just sat down just, well, literally 2 hours ago with President Trump for an exclusive interview, and they spoke about him declassifying the FISA documents, Mueller's probe, Kavanaugh's confirmation process, and so much more. I don't even know where to begin. I'll let you report, and we'll all decide, but this is an exclusive interview that he gave you, what, 45 minutes for the Hill?
It was extraordinary in the Oval Office. And first, Sean, just one thing, an impression before we get to the news. You hear all the stories of the White House being in disarray, chaos, yelling, screaming. I was in the Oval Office for 45 minutes. The president couldn't be calmer. The organization couldn't be more functional. And he was very measured in how he answered questions, very detailed. He had a good grasp of the details of the Russia investigation and anything we asked him. It was really impressive, so different from the reports that you see in the other news media organizations today. But let me tell you the news. He said today that the effort to expose a corrupt FBI investigation may turn out to be one of the crowning achievements of his presidency, that what went on was a ruse. He changed his word. He's been calling it a witch hunt. Remember sure. Mueller's witch hunt? Today, he used Greg Jarrett's word. It's a hoax. It was a fraud. We deceived the FISA court. He made some really strong statements about the judges. I don't know yet, he said, but I fear they didn't do their job. Maybe they're doing it now. We got to give them the benefit of the doubt.
Meaning the
but
FISA
they didn't
court
ask
judges?
Enough. Yeah, first time he's ever talked about that, right? But here's one of the biggest ones. We've sat here for 2 years laboring over the idea, was there obstruction when he fired Comey, right? And, of course, a lot of people said it was in his constitutional power. Here's the news he made today. He said he wanted to fire Comey back in 2016. He should have done it. He got talked out of it. It was the biggest mistake. He didn't fire him in May. That wasn't the first time he was thinking about it. He thought about it in the summer of 2016. He wanted to get rid of that guy because he didn't like the way he handled the Clinton email case. All of this has been under wraps. We have known this. It puts an entirely different perspective on the things the president did in his first months in office. Really extraordinary.
You know, we have been unpeeling an onion, and you've been a big part of it. Greg has been a big part of it. Sarah's been a big part of it. And there's been many others. I can't mention them all. I think he's right. Did he also talk about declassifying and unredacting other stuff?
He did.
He did?
Yeah. Here's the most important thing. He hasn't even read these documents. He's taking a leap of faith that the American public will appreciate the transparency. I haven't read them, but I'm certain from the members of Congress I've talked to who've done their work and done their due diligence, it's going to show that we were disserved in the American public, that this was a hoax and not a real investigation meant to distract my presidency. But he's a man very comfortable with his decision to declassify. All that Brennan stuff rolls off his sleeve like nothing. He believes this is the right thing to do, and he believes when we see these documents, we're going to find out the FBI did not act in the best interest of the United States. That was his words and what he came away with today when we talked to him.
There seems to be a lot of fear. We mentioned this with Sarah in terms of Brennan and McCabe with his new book. Really? Terrorism? Trump? Really?
Yeah.
It's sad.
Yeah.
This is one of the greatest institutions. Yeah, I've said this many times. A lot of my family is in law enforcement. My mom was a prison guard for 25 years. My dad, family court probation. So many. It's an Irish family. Cops. NYPD. Two
Same
FBI
here.
Guys were deity, and this is not rank and file. But what they did is abuse their power. Is he confident that we do get to the truth?
He does. He had a level of confidence and a level of composure that this is the right thing to do, and when we're all done, we're all going to agree what happened here. He said privately Democrats are now telling him you've been deserved on some of this stuff. He's a man that is on a mission to clear his name, but also to get the American people to understand what the FBI did wrong and how to make sure it never happens again.
John Solomon. It's on thehill.com. We'll link it to Hannity.com. Great job. 45-minute exclusive interview with the president. He'll have all the details for you.